What's up, guys? Welcome to Rockin' the Country. I'm Don, and today I'm doing the one and only Miranda Lambert song, What About Georgia? And it's from her 2005 album, Kerosene, which, like, is, and well, all of her albums are ridiculous, but that album was just unreal. And, well, firstly, this was requested by Southern Girl, G-Y-R-L, which I love that. I don't know why, but I just do. And I love Southern Girl, so how could you not like that name? All that said, what do you say about Miranda? I mean, I could talk about her forever. She's so talented. But when you consider, I think Miranda is only like 35 years old right now, that this album, Kerosene, that means that she did it, she was like 22. So for somebody to have that kind of talent at that age, 22, 23, assuming I have my numbers correct, is just unbelievable to me. Some people you just look at and you're like, wow, you're doing... It's almost like you came out of the womb meant to do this and you found that. And I don't necessarily believe that that's how life works. I think that life is lived by trial and error. You try some things and for whatever reason, it doesn't quite work for who you are or for the people you're with or whatever doesn't work. But every so often, it seems like enough things go right that a person finds themselves doing something that is so well suited to them. You know, there are certain ballet dancers that from a young age, in fact, most professionals knew at a young age, that's what they wanted to be. And the discipline and dedication required, for example, to be a professional ballet dancer. The suffering, the pain, the drive, the endurance, the patience, the striving, the strength, all of that required, for example, in the ballet world, required to get to those highest levels, to be dancing in a professional company or a world-renowned professional company is beyond anything I'd seen. And in any case, so when I see like a Miranda Lambert at this level, it's like she had to have known at a young age, dedicated herself to it, and but is comfortable in her own shoes to present herself to the world as herself. And that's a whole nother level as well. Like you can be technically proficient at something and good at something, but then to be comfortable enough with yourself to say, here I am, I hope you don't reject me. That's another thing to admire about people who are at the tops of their profession. They didn't have it all together. They still don't have it all together. Even Miranda, you know, it doesn't matter what field you're in. There's still that fear that your next song, your next album, your next performance is going to flop. And, you know, and other parts, you know, of life that may or may not go your way. And we all have those fears, no matter the level of success we have. So I look at people like Miranda and I'm like, those are the things I marvel at. Like, wow, so many things that you went for and you risked and it worked and you're actually cut out for this type of work and presentation and you're at the top of your game. So, yeah, if you see this, Miranda, you'll know why I appreciate you and then some. All right, here we go with What About Georgia? Southern Girl, this one's for you.
You draw it out like a highway with every word that you say. Excuses for the answers that you lack. Your mama's still the steady ground you walk on every day. And your daddy's still the monkey on your back. Did you find all you thought you'd find out in the wild, wild west? You took a little piece of home and you threw away the rest. Turn 33, are
I'm still trying to figure out what that line means. I've heard this song a lot, but are you still? Are you the one man you want to be by the time that you turn 33, or are you still a bullet in your daddy's gun? I'm still trying. Leave comments about what that means, because some of you guys write some of the most eloquent, brilliant explanations for some things that I'm like astounded, humbled, thankful, all that when I read some of the things that you write. It's like, wow, this is a person who could be like a college professor and I'd like to study at their feet. Here we go.
Don't forget, boy, you're your mama's only son. She's been praying for you. So what about Georgia?
Mama's praying for you. Is Georgia her mother's name?
I saw your sister yesterday. Austin's five and on his way. Looking for some shoes that he can fill. He said that he'd be just like you, the coolest guy he ever knew. When he found you, when he lost his training wheels. Looked in his big blue eyes and I saw you again. He's hungry for a life that he ain't ready to begin. Say you're living on the edge and I think you're hanging from a ledge. Too scared to hold a hand that wants to help you up.
That is a great line. And it's so true in life. It resonates with me. What? Too scared to hold the hand that wants to help you up. How often do we not want to reach out for help? And I mean, I've done that in the past. People that are wanting to help me in whatever. Could be big, medium, little. And whether maybe I didn't feel worthy of it. Maybe I was afraid of a relationship. Whatever it might have been. But those are powerful words right there. That, I mean, too scared to hold the hand that wants to help you up. So much of life, you have to depend on other people, but we don't want to trust as much because maybe we got burned or maybe we're just, I want to say a jerk or something like that. I've definitely been that before in my life. But yeah, like what is it that keeps us blocking things that would be good for us? I don't know. Psychologists try to figure that thing out all the time.
You the man you thought you'd be by the time that you turned 33. Are you still a bullet in your daddy's gun? Well, don't forget, boy, you're your mama's only son. She's at home and she's been praying for you. So what about Georgia?
You know that line, the way it worked, like, are you still a bullet in your daddy's gun? But, like, don't forget that you're your mama's only son, so what about Georgia? I'm guessing Georgia's the mom's name. Either that or she lives in Georgia. I'm trying to figure all this out. There's a lot compressed lyrically into the song. But part of me thinks, is this about divorce, too? Like, did the mom and dad get divorced? And because sometimes parents pit kids against one another, you know, in divorces. And it's horrible, but they use visitation rights and all that stuff. But I don't think that's what this is about because he's 33 years old in this song. And typically the parents can't use the kids in the same way when they're grown like that. When they're teenagers, yeah, early 20s. But by the time the kids are old enough to figure things out, the parents can't really pit one another. So I don't know what that bullet in your daddy's gun means.
Guess you didn't realize it'd take you quite this long to figure out that being free is right where you belong. Say you're living on the edge and I think you're hanging from a ledge. Too scared hold the hand that wants to help you up. Hey, are you the man you thought you'd be by the time that you turn 33? Are you still a bullet in your daddy's gun? Well, don't forget, boy, you're your mama's only son.
You know, every time I've heard that song, I've heard different things in it. This is the most intensely that I've sort of analyzed it, but I have thought deeply about this song before. Are you still a bullet in your daddy's gun? Could just be like a metaphor for like, are you still basically just like a sperm in your dad? Like, have you even been born yet? Like, when are you going to come into your own? Are you the man that you want to be? Like, or are you just still a bullet in your daddy's gun? Like, really, you haven't even come into your own at all yet. It's like you've not even been born. Afraid to hold a hand and wants to hold you up. Don't forget, your mother's at home praying for you. You live, you exist. You're her only son. Maybe it means that, you know. I mean, that does make sense, whether that's the expression that's being employed here. I don't know, but, you know, Miranda is very good at singing slow songs, which are harder to sing than fast songs because there's more of yourself on display in moving slowly through a song, not just technically, but emotionally. There's so many components. When you're moving slowly, it's you. It's you they're looking at. And they could spend their time looking more slowly at different parts of your body alignment and your expression and your movement and your portrayal of what the choreographer set on you. And with that in mind, you need the mental strength to say, I believe in what I'm doing. I'm confident in front of these people on the stage, just being me, moving slowly. And if it works, it works. But it's scarier. Moving quickly, your mistakes are hidden. It's more about the athleticism of the movement. And to bring that like analogy into singing, Miranda still, I'm just blown away. Even, you know, 22 or 23 years old is not a baby any longer, but it's also not a full-grown artist. And she still pulled this off. The way her cadence, her intonations, the way she goes through a song with a lot of lyrics in it. It's just still so impressive to me. So that's why her career did what it did and does what it does. So, all right, Southern Girl, that one was for you. Can I rate a song that, like, I'm stuck on what the one impression means? Yeah, I can rate. No, I'm not going to rate this one. I have to leave this one be just because I need to know more about what is being said in it. So, maybe I'll do the song again in a year after you guys explain it to me what it means, because I know some of you will explain it to me. So thank you in advance. TIA, people. All right, there it is, guys. There's Miranda Lambert's What About Georgia? And have a great day. Subscribe if you haven't yet. Please join the family, and we'll all go from there. Have a great day. Keep rocking the country.